Today we have landed the Future Stars objective card, Reinier. 87 rated striker from Borussia Dortmund. Internationally, he plays for the team of Brazil. So that's already insane, because normally any striker that comes from Brazil tends to be pretty good. He is 6'1". He's got high medium work rate, 4-star skill moves, with a 4-star weak foot. When it comes to chem styles, the Hunter chem style is the chem style I've personally gone for. And usually for strikers, I tend to actually move towards the Hunter chem style instead of the Marksman or the Hawk chem style. Now those stats were already at a pretty decent level, but I felt like his sprint speed needed to be a bit higher for him to be able to kind of fall in the place of being in my dream team. The Hunter chemistry style focuses on the pace and the shooting. It puts the acceleration up to 99, sprint speed up to 99 as well. I mean, wow, like maxing that out, it just makes it an unbelievable card, out of this world. And I will explain to you what this guy has achieved in such a short period of time on Foot Champs shortly after this section of the video. Now let's move on to shooting. The possession, 87. So the attacking positioning, 87 currently. With that added 5 on, that would be over 90. Adding on to the finishing, 87, add 10, that makes it 97, which is hella good. Shot power, 92, add the 5 on, makes it 97. Long shots, 82. I mean, you're not really going to be shooting from long range with this guy, but right outside the box is more than enough. Volleys, 99. And penalties, oh my days, up to 96. Wow, incredible. The rest is good enough. One thing about this objective card that's a little bit disappointing is in fact the player traits. Now, I expected him to have a few more player traits, but it looks like they have not really added any to him. And I really hope it doesn't end up affecting his performance in the game. And another interesting thing is, If we go ahead and look at the skill moves and weak foot stars, 4 stars each, fair enough. But when Reinier was moving up the ranks from, I think, the 82 rated Reinier, then I think it went to 85, then to 87. At no point, from what I remember, did his skill moves ever go up. So it remained the same. Now, it would have been nice if there was a bit of an increase, because the card does go up quite a lot in rating. As you remember from my previous video, he was the guy that I will have at the end in my dream team. And his performance in Foot Champs really cements that. Now, let's just take a look at the stats here. Games played and goals scored. And also, let's not run past the assists as well. Now, I used Reinier specifically for Foot Champs. My main striker for a long period of time was Suarez, and he is an incredible finisher, but he lacks the pace. Even if you add an additional chemistry style onto his card, or the best chemistry style, which would be a Hunter, it would put his pace up a little bit, but it wouldn't be at the same level as Ranier's pace. Now remember what I said, his pace was around 98, and his shooting as well was around the 98 mark. So to have that ability by just applying a Hunter card makes him a deadly piece of weapon up front. And as you guys can see, he's played 36 games and scored 63 games. Now, I played 30 of those games online. 30, not just any online game, 30 Foot Champ games. Now, interestingly, on Foot Champs, I was hoping to open up my rewards. But this is weird, because play division rivals to qualify for the upcoming competition. Now, must be a glitch here, because I don't know if you guys can see, I had 14 wins, win matches to rank up, 14 wins in total, and I was supposed to be coming on today and getting 2,000 Foot Champ points, which would allow me to qualify for the next weekend Foot Champs. An additional 30k coins, which is a hefty amount, and will help me on the way to getting Soboslai. Now, 2 mega packs and 1 rare player pack. Tradable, which is insane. So I'm expected to get some decent players there. I was hoping that Foot Champ players would be tradable, but that's not the case. But we're getting 2 in total, so that's 6 players to choose from. I'm hoping we're going to get someone 85 and above, ideally German. But if not, Spanish or a player from the Premier League would be ideal. 30 games, 14 wins, 16 losses, which is... considering the teams that I had to play against, I think that's a decent record. And this is the first Foot Champs I've ever experienced. And trust me, those 14 wins were the hardest wins of my career. And the fact that I pulled 14 wins out of 30 games is a very, very decent record for myself. Now, bear in mind that, as explained before, I had scored at least 2 to 3 goals in the other 16 games that we played. But unfortunately, I just conceded 4, 5, 6 goals. And defending constant, having constant pressure from those strikers that I had to play against. Like, we're talking about in-form Messi, in-form Ronaldo, icons like Ronaldo, 97 rated Ronaldo. I mean, I didn't see Puskas. He probably would have destroyed me just as badly. But yeah, it was, that's the type of teams we were playing against. Straight away, my eyes feast on the beast that is Puskas. The almighty Hungarian has received an upgrade. The sad thing is, it's only by 1. And I expected a little bit more of an increase, considering Ronaldo's at 97. Now, no disrespect to Ronaldo being a 97 card, but Puskas was on the exact same level as Ronaldo, or better in my opinion. And I don't get why he's 95. He has a few different cards for sure, and this is his highest rated card, but something's not really right there. Icon swaps too, as they've named it. Complete player token objectives to receive player tokens and redeem them for rewards. Now, I kind of missed out on this on the first season, so I'm definitely going to take 100% of my time to focus as much as I can in getting all 18 player tokens. Now, from the screenshot that I can see here, it looks like the first 9 are available now from February the 19th all the way to the March 26th. So we've got around a week, 5 days to get 9 player tokens. That's going to be tough work. Now, from March 26th to May 7th, there's going to be another 9 player tokens available, which I think would be more doable as there is a far bigger amount of time for us to get it done. Oh, February 19th. I mean, they gave us a month, March, April. Oh, that's almost 2 months, yeah. Okay, so here's Puskas and here's Ronaldo. Both of these players are in my dream team. Obviously, I'm only going to go for Puskas, not Ronaldo. But he's a great player. Now, let's dive into their icon profiles. And this is my reasoning behind why Puskas overall is a better player. I think the fact that his reign was back in the 1960s, and I guess people are not fully aware of his accomplishments, maybe that's why he's slightly lower than Ronaldo. But they definitely do respect him by giving him a solid rating of 95. That's 4 below the maximum rating. So what am I complaining about? Now, let's take a look at this. The greatest players produced extraordinary performances on the biggest stages, and Ferenc Puskas did just that in the 1960 European Cup final. Real Madrid overcame Frankfurt in an thrilling 7-3 victory at Hampden Park in Glasgow, in which Puskas netted 4 of his side's 7 goals, all of which came from attempts inside the penalty area. The goals were vital in taking the game away from Frankfurt and reaching a 5th European Cup title in a row for the Los Blancos, that being Real Madrid. Now, let's take a look at his club career. He played for a Hungarian league team, Budapest Honvéd, and this might be the reason why his rating is lower than Ronaldo's, because the Hungarian league, he was there for 13 years. The Hungarian league back then, might not have been as competitive as it is now, but you could argue that it was, because the fact that he was able to also perform and literally score just as many goals as appearances for Real Madrid, plus looking over to the national career, the fact that he was scoring 84 goals in 85 games, I mean, I don't think we should downgrade his team, Budapest Honvéd. I reckon the Hungarian league was in a better state back then. So yeah, and he played 4 games for Spain. I don't even know why he decided to go and play for Spain. I think it was just retirement. They might have paid him a bit more, but yeah. But this is what I mean. Like, look at those stats. Ronaldo doesn't have these kind of stats. Let's go over to him. He's a great player. He definitely will have good stats. Now, okay. So this might be one of the reasons why he's rated 97. The fact that he played for as many clubs as he did. But if you take a look at the years that he played for the clubs, I would say there wasn't a lot of loyalty going on there. His longest reign was with Inter Milan. 99 games played, 59 goals scored. Decent record. 1 year for playing for Barcelona, he had a very good record. 49 appearances, 47 goals. PSV, 57 appearances, 54 goals. All right, these stats do add up very, very nicely, and I understand why he is rated the way he is. 177 appearances, 104 goals, pretty decent. And going over to a 17-year career with Brazil, 98 apps and 62 goals. Now, I have a feeling the fact that he did win the World Cup with Brazil, retaining it, Brazil may not have been able to retain the FIFA World Cup in 2006, but it was certainly a successful tournament on a personal level for Ronaldo. After bagging 2 goals in the group stage match against Japan, Ronaldo scored a record-breaking 15 World Cup finals goals during the round of 16 match against Ghana. He beat the offside trap with an ease and skillfully rounded the keeper before rolling the ball into an empty net to break the then record, which I think is held by Miroslav Klose now. Respect to that guy. So yeah, I think the reason why maybe this rating is higher than Puskas is because simply the fact that he won the World Cup. Now, Puskas took Hungary to 2 World Cup finals. I reckon Hungary should have won. Hungary should now have 2 World Cup wins, in my personal opinion. If they had VAR, they definitely would have had two of those for sure. But hey, I mean, they didn't, so it was up to the gods, right? But Ronaldo won the World Cup a few times, and I think this is why they've given him a high rating. And quite possibly, maybe because of the fact that he was able to play in multiple different leagues and showcase his skill by scoring just as many goals. Though, on the other hand, Mr. Puskas had a better career in Real Madrid. So Ronaldo had 177 appearances and 104 goals. If we go back to Puskas, he actually had 262 appearances with 242 goals. Wow. Now that's a better record. That's at the same level as Cristiano Ronaldo's. So, I say no more. All I have to say to that is bring it on.